Rick and I have been racing now for 34 years. That's a lot of miles. And especially for these little legs of mine that's still moving. It has taken a toll on my body.
51 years ago, Dick Hoyt was told that his son Rick, born with a severe form of cerebral palsy, should be institutionalized, that he would never have a normal life. But Dick believed in his son and taught him that together they could overcome anything. And so, despite the fact that Dick had never before competed in a single race, they started running, father pushing son. In 1981, they ran their first marathon in their hometown of Boston. They would forever after feel a special connection to this race.
When we got on the course, people were cheering, and there was great excitement and support for us. When we got to the finish line, someone gave me a blanket, just like all the other athletes, and that proved I belonged.
Since then, they have participated in over 1,000 races together, inspiring the world with one parent's selfless act of love for his child. So this April, the city of Boston unveiled a statue at the starting line of the marathon, a monument to these two men, who haven't broken any records for distance or time, but who have set the standard for determination and perseverance. And the Hoyts, after 31 years of competition, decided to end their long-distance career right where it all began.
It was a beautiful day, and we had a great start. And then we got to about 22, 23 mile marker, and I just looked and I said, it seems like there's more police around than normal.
We're interrupting your program because there have been two explosions today at the Boston Marathon. There are a lot of people down.
The finish line at Copley Square had been reduced to chaos and pain.
We just couldn't believe that somebody would do that, just go in and set up bombs to kill anybody. They didn't care who it was or anything else. It was just so sad.
On Monday morning, the sun rose over Boston. In an instant, the day's beauty was shattered. A celebration became a tragedy. But in the words of Dick Hoyt, who's pushed his disabled son, Rick, in 31 Boston marathons, we can't let something like this stop us.
This was planned to be our last Boston marathon, but because of the tragedy, we plan to honor those who were killed and injured by running one last time.
This time, when they run the marathon, it will be more than a father pushing his son across the finish line. They will be a team, finishing a race on behalf of an entire city. A city that has given them as much as they have given to it.
I still experience the same wonderful feelings I felt during our very first race. If I had to sum up all I have learned by competing in long-distance events, it all boils down to remembering that, yes, you can. And never, never give up.
The Hoyts.
I want to thank all of you for giving such a warm welcome to a couple of stubborn Boston guys. We want to put you at our best foot forward. So I'm going to let my son, the college grad, talk first.
I am so excited to be here in LA to receive the Jimmy V. Perseverance Award. I can hardly believe we are here. 37 years ago, nobody would even talk to us, but because my dad said yes when I asked him to push me in the first race, and my family, especially my brothers Rob and Russ, have always stood by us and helped us persevere, even with so many people telling us that we did not belong, we are here. It only proves the wisdom of Jimmy V's words, don't give up, don't ever give up. And as you might imagine, we are even more thrilled because the life motto of Team Hoyt, which has inspired thousands of people around the world to better themselves through athletics and to not tolerate people with disabilities being denied the opportunity to participate in life is yes, you can.
Rick is my inspiration. He has taught me great many things over the years, and every day I consider myself lucky to be his father and teammate. I don't think you could find two guys more proud to represent the city of Boston. Next time you see someone in a wheelchair or who can't talk or walk, or they may talk or walk a little bit different, they are people too and deserve to be able to live, learn, work, and play. Rick and I want to thank you all.